to Open Hack Europe and welcome you all to our event today. We're so pleased to be here. You cannot believe it. This event has taken many months in the making. It's really, really great to see a full house. So thank you for coming. This is the third Open Hack that we've had in Europe. The first two were in London, and this is the first one that we've had in mainland Europe. It's the 14th Open Hack that we've run around the world. And it's so great to be with us today. We like to think of Open Hacks as a celebration of technology and creativity, a celebration of Yahoo and what it means to be a Yahoo. The Open Hack program that we run externally came from our internal innovation initiatives. And we're really proud of what we get out of these and what everybody who comes to them gets out of it. Looks like we've pretty much got a full house. I don't know how many people came through the door, but we had over 400 people registered for Hackers and 300 registered for the Tech Talks. Can you put your hand up if you're a hacker? Brilliant. Well done. And put your hand up if you're a Tech Talk. Great. So what's going to happen is the hackers are going to be with us for the next 36 hours. We don't lock the doors, so if you do want to leave and come back, then you can. But if you want to get the most out of the event, I'd recommend that you stick with us throughout the whole event. We've got a place at the very back of the venue where you'd rather be there and go have a seat for a couple of hours if you need it. Or you can just hack all the way through and stick with coffee in the venue. For the Tech Talk people, you're going to be here for this morning's talks. Then we're going to invite you to have lunch with us and then ask you kindly to leave. Then we're going to invite you back again for tomorrow's presentations so you can see all the hacks that are produced by the hackers, which should start around 2 p.m. tomorrow. It's going to take a couple of hours to run, and then there'll be some judging, and we'll have a look at some awards and gifts and a few deals together. So if you are here just for Tech Talks, please come back tomorrow and we'll see what happens. Okay, so I'm going to be talking you through your essential guide to hack and hack events, particularly this event. I'm going to be talking a bit about what a hack is, what a hacker is, and just as importantly, what it isn't. I'm going to be talking about what's going to happen over the next 34 hours, a little bit more detail, so you know what to expect from the event. And I'm going to tell you a little bit about how to get the most out of this event. This is a very long event, there's lots of stuff going on, and there's some simple guidelines that if you follow, you'll get a lot out of it. So, I'm going to kick off with a little bit of information about what a hacker is and what a hacker isn't. The word hacker means different things depending on who you ask. If you ask someone in the media, they might tell you a hacker is a criminal who breaks into computer systems. If you ask someone in the movies, they might tell you a hacker is a spy who breaks into computer systems to steal secrets for espionage reasons. But if you ask someone in computer science circles what a hacker is, they will tell you that a hacker is a term of great respect for someone who is creative, loves building things with technology, and is just generally awesome. So these are very different meanings, and it's important that you understand why we're here today. We're not here for the former two, we're here for the latter. Many technology companies reserve the term hacker or the job title hacker for the best people in the organization, the folks that get stuff right. So hacker for us is that it's a term of great respect given to people who love technology, love being creative with technology. So hacker is not equal to cracker. So if you look around you and you see anyone who looks like that, then you ask them to leave. Anyone leaving? Okay. So, no. Right. Bad news here. Angelina Jolie isn't coming. John Travolta isn't coming. And neither is Wolverine or the other one. So, no. We're not espionage for the time. So, this is more like it. This looks more like the people in the audience. This is a project from one of the previous hackers in Europe. So, you know, our training is wear the hacker badge of pride, and if you're here from the media, please don't give us a write-up like this. Okay. Right, so now we're going to know what We're going to talk about a little bit about what a hack is. So a hack is a solution to a real world problem. A solution has been devised and implemented in a time and resource starved situation, like say 24 hours. So the reason this is a software development month, it's a hack day, it's an event that lasts for a short amount of time. You guys have a challenge of creating, coming up with a problem to solve, devising a solution, technical solution to that problem, and then building that solution within 24 hours. And that's quite tough to do. So in order to meet that challenge, you're going to have to be creative, be innovative, and use already existing components that already exist out there on the web, other backup technologies, other backup technologies, data from somewhere else in the web. You find them an interesting and novel way to solve the problem that you have chosen to solve. So a couple of examples of hacks. So we have an Egyptian revolution hack here. So in this situation where comets are rare and you know, revolutions that spin up very quickly, you haven't got much time. Right? So you have to use the resources that you have around you to solve the problem. So we have a solar bottle helmet and a bottle helmet. Another one here is a human embargo hack. So in the absence of motorbike parks or motorbikes, this young fellow decided to use a little motorbike from a long direction, a bike, and a solar bottle. Very ingenious. So we're here, of course, to build technology hacks. So it's important that we focus on those. If you do want to build, if you want to create a bottle helmet, you can. However, you won't get much interest from the judges to do that. This hack is a good example of a hack we've seen before at OpenHack. This was created by one of the winners of the previous OpenHack in Brazil. It's a visualization of data with a time dimension, but it's not through an animation, where it takes data from the web through an open API access to Formula One's course for the history of Formula One since 1994. And it visualizes that data in an interesting way that I should build it. So what you can do is you can choose any year from 1959 to 2009 when the hack is built. And then you can animate that season and see how each of the races went throughout the course of the season and how the various drivers scored throughout that. So it's a very interesting visualization of data. Many of the hacks that we see are visualizations or mashups of data. If you want to see other examples of good hacks, go to visithackme.com/hacks. What you'll see there is a whole bunch of hacks built on Yahoo Technologies and APIs that were built by Christian Holland. So if you want to get a better feel for what Yahoo Technologies are, go to see the list of them. Okay, so whatever you build, it's important to extract your knowledge. Eric Berlin in his famous book, Cathedral and the Bazaar, said that every good work of software starts by scratching a developer's itch. If you solve an interesting problem, start by finding a problem that is interesting to you. That's the best advice that you get today. Okay, so now that we know about hackers and what a hack is, we're going to talk a little bit about what OpenHack is. So OpenHack, what we try to do here is create an environment where creativity can thrive and try to engage developers within that environment with mapping and other open web technologies. The hack concept itself, first came about in Yahoo internally in 2005, and it was actually Chad Dickerson came up with it. He was challenged by coming up with an innovation initiative. Get the most out of the company's staff. And he had a simple belief that not just executives could come up with great ideas for products, but designers and developers in the organization can come up with really great ideas too. So he came up with a simple mechanism to make that happen or happen. Two simple rules that he came up with are take something from idea to prototype in a day, and get it at the end of the day in 2 minutes or less, usually less. We usually give about 90 seconds for demos, which is a lot of time, depending on how many you get, but you get that information more. So, just to reiterate the environment that we're creating, if you were chefs, then the environment that we create would be a kitchen with a with all the others, and all the flowers, and the spring ingredients, and the best things. Production, of course, for computer scientists and designers, so the environment we create that we see around us today, the mission and the four elements for the world. So the ingredients that we're adding into this program are data from the web, Yahoo's open APIs, as well as other open APIs across the web. Back in 2009, Tendai RSD made a call for raw data now at the TED Talk, and people listened. Governments around the world have been opening their data to the open web, so have scientific institutions, historical institutions. Open data is everywhere on the web now, and it is just waiting there to be used by you in a unique and interesting way, and being available to the world. Just an example of the UK's open government data program. Go to developer.yahoo.com if you want to find Yahoo's open APIs and content. Programmable web is a great place to go for open APIs. There's over 3,000 there. So you can search by category for any type of category that you're interested in and find data there. Reddit also has a great excerpt page for that. And the Guardian recently, over the last couple of years, has been, every time I write an article based on some data, starting with some research, it will publish more data to the right as well, so other people can use it and provide it in new and unique ways. Another good example of open data working is Transport for London. Transport for London realized that they're not a software development house. They don't have the capacity to create the size and number of apps that are going to make one of those sites useful. So they just opened up their raw data and let other people build businesses and applications on top of that. The create one of those sites easier. So these people are building businesses on top of it, such as iPhone apps that let people in London find more spikes in various locations or find an empty stand to people that they've got in. These people are making the money from this, but they're also driving forward the agenda for Transport for London as well. So it's a great partnership between the company and developers as well. Okay, so that's the ingredients, that's the tools. We've brought to you today some of the very best Yahoo developers, from various developer product groups, to tell you all about the great tools that Yahoo has for building apps and hacking, as well as for how you use these in your business. We've got some of the YUI team, or YPL team, or POS team, or Messenger team. They are all going to be talking to you today this morning. Okay, so we've got ingredients, we've got great tools, so we add experts. These are our technical methods of the platform. Then the final ingredient to make this environment complete is you. Without you, this is just a shell environment and nothing will happen. You're the most important ingredient here, and we are here to help you be creative and have some great hacks and updates at the end of the day. Okay, so enough of the chef analogy. OpenHack EU3. So what's going to happen over the next 34 hours? So if you're probably all aware of the keyboards with you right now, this is a key source of information throughout the event, and it's also going to be where you're going to register your hacks tomorrow. So keep an eye on this. Even though you have a schedule in your welcome pack, schedules can change, you look at one, but if it does, we'll update the schedule on the wiki. Unfortunately, we can't update it on the welcome pack. Okay, so if you're on Twitter, follow us on OpenHackMe. All of the anything that happens in the event will be tweeted out there by having all that. So if the entertainment's about to start, we'll be tweeting about it. If food is about to be served somewhere, we'll be tweeting about it. If something interesting happens that we notice, we'll be tweeting about it. So keep an eye on the stream to hear what's happening across the venue. It is a big venue, there's five fairly large size rooms, so not really know what's going on across the whole thing unless you keep an eye on the stream. Okay, we also have a hashtag, so if you're tweeting about the event and you want other people to see the tweet, use the hashtag OpenHackEU. And if you're taking photos of the event, please upload them to Flickr so we can all enjoy them too. Use the Flickr tag OpenHackEU11. Right, so a little bit more on the menu. As you can see, there's five rooms here. We're on the main room on the left. The next one along is the second track room. So there's going to be some talks there at the story end as well. We're going to be quite thick about it in this motion. Next one is the engine. We've got some fun games to play. Sometimes you can be stuck with a problem and you've got 2 hours flat on the pack, you just want to take a break. Look at the engine, play on the Wii, play on the Xbox. We'll have some Jagger Jagger, ping pong together at the end of it. Above each of these other rooms have a balcony. So above the engine, so the press committee, general press at the stadium. So we've accidentally got to trouble hackers whilst they're working. However, we will want to talk to some of you guys about the event. So if you want to talk to the press, then let me know. I'll be around talking to you and see what's going on. And if I think it goes to be interesting, I'll be suggesting to talk to the press. It was absolutely no requirement we would have to talk to the press. Left the long quiet area, so there's going to be a lot of action happening in this room. The majority of the hackers will be in this room. But if you want to get to a quieter area to work, then you can go to that one. But there is the staff room where a lot of the hackers are going to be. And at the very end of the venue, we've got PC, so there's no Wi-Fi there, probably just quite weak Wi-Fi from the room next door. So if you need to sleep at any point, grab the email, get over there, yeah, get some kit, and then get back to it when you're ready. Right, so this morning we've got a bunch of tech talks that I'm ready for you guys. They're happening in 2 weeks. This one, the one next door. At 10 a.m. this afternoon, it's going to be Jonathan Burr. He's going to be talking about working on. After Jonathan, we'll have Luke Smith, who's going to be talking about writing on 3. Then we're going to have Patrick talking about accessibility, innovations, and challenges. Followed by Reed Perk, who's going to be talking about Node.js. In track 2, we're going to have Raul talking about BOSS, which is Dan's Node.js search extraction technology. Finally, we're going to have Vivek Agarwal, who's going to be talking about ESCO. Actually, the next one is Harold, who's going to be doing Spotted. He's going to be doing 2 talks today. Firstly, at 12:30, we'll be talking about server sides, talking about server side JavaScript from a theoretical perspective. Reed is going to be talking about Node.js specifically, so those two talks are going to talk about each other. I don't think one of those things much introduction is very well known in the community, founder of the JSON Data Exchange format, and also work with the JavaScript within part. Throughout the event, you're going to find people with t-shirts just like Aaron, green t-shirt. These are going to be staff. These guys are going to be able to help you. Many of them are going to be Yak technical guys who are going to be wandering the venue, finding out what they're working on, and helping you with any Yak technologies that you need to help them. If you need to find those over there are a table over there with a couple of rooms above it. You see? So all of those guys are going to help you. So if you need help with any of the technologies that I mentioned, go there and find the guys and help you out. So hacking is going to begin after the talks. So you have 24 hours to go hack, and then we'll leave our clock on the board here, which will then help out 24 hours to go start. You don't have that much time to go hack, so there's a simple strategy that we're going to have is once you decide what idea you want to build, tackle the hard problems first. Right? So don't leave until the end because at 2 o'clock in the morning, your brain's not going to work as well as it's going to start. And you might run into a problem that you just can't solve in the time. So if you tackle the hard problems first, you'll be able to abandon the idea and start a new one early enough to save You'll also be asked to register your hack tomorrow by 12 p.m. And hacking will end around 1 p.m. tomorrow. Okay, just after the hacking call rings, we're going to be having a chance to go to these enthusiast sessions. If you've come up with a fully formed team and a fully formed idea and you just want to get going, then just do that. However, if you're still unsure about exactly what you're going to do, or you're what you need to build up like a team together and you want to meet like-minded people. Or if you just want to objective of these sessions is to have you meet like-minded people, to talk about ideas with, to hear from subject matter experts in various categories who can help you with your idea in your mind. So the first enthusiast session we've got is a hardware enthusiast session. This is going to be done by a guy called Vero Steele, who's from RoboFund. What is robots to the event? So the global city robots, build those robots. He's also brought some spare hardware that you can borrow from them to build a hat. So Vero's going to be there for the talks and the detailed session about Arduino development and then programming. You will also have the opportunity in these enthusiast sessions if you want to talk about a relevant topic of interest to you. To sign up for a lightning talk, and Vero will help do that at hardware room. We'll also be at Epoxio's Oxford store. So if you have an idea that you need a designer or a front-end developer or a back-end developer for your team, you can write your idea, the name on the board, and then specify what you need for your team so other people can find you. Also, if you have some skills like a front-end developer, but you don't have an idea of a team yet, specify your skills on the board, and then tell them an idea. These are skills. We've also got a history enthusiast session going on. That's led by Matt Harrison, who's over there, right? Matt recently ran History Hack in London, a very successful event at the Guardian offices. He's here with Dan Kerr from the British Museum and John Pugh from the National Archives. And they've got lots of interesting, valuable historical data that they can introduce you to if you want to build a history hack. We're going to ask one of the enthusiast guys to come up here to continue the fish to the next thing. We have Roxandra Palma from TechSoup here. Roxandra's over there. She's going to be running an enthusiast session on civil society. So she's brought with her some folks from civil society, like Winnie Buzzy from Mexico, Romania, and Madeline McCann from the Center for Democracy. So they're going to be presenting on essentially how technology can improve society, and I think lots of great ideas as to the way great hacks that would have a life beyond this event that can help to improve the local society in a very way. So definitely a worthwhile activity. So go on to that one if you want to change the role. Okay, so next one we have a mixed enthusiast session. So we only have four projectors in the event, so we've got hardware, civil society, and history happening separately. They'll be in the next room and the game room. We've also got a mixed session. So this is a combination of folks with various interests. For example, we have Valentin Carmenetti from the National Physicist from the Institute of State Science. He's got lots of great data on the distribution of black holes in the universe and galaxies in the universe. So if you want to build a hack that can progress astrophysics, then talk to him. It's interesting that he can help you with maths, he can help you with programming. We also have Dragos Mirza from Microspace, who's got lots of data on spaceships and the technical details of spaceships. He's going to be talking about this. And Nick Dillon is a music enthusiast, who's going to be talking about music with maths. If you if you're enthusiastic about a particular topic that's not either civil society, hardware, or this history, then you can go along to this mixed enthusiast session and sign up for a lightning talk with the API or whatever idea you're excited about, a hack idea, and you can present that to folks there. So the purpose of these enthusiast sessions is to help you meet like-minded people, help you find, help you form teams, learn from the experts, come up with an idea, and get hacking as soon as possible. So they'll be running for about an hour. Okay, so we'll be supplying lots of packaging drinks throughout the event. We expect to get thousands of cups of coffee. We expect you to get thousands of cups of coffee. We also have Red Bull coming in sometime and giving away a free Red Bull. But we'll also have breakfast, lunches, and dinners at the appropriate times as well. So check your schedule before you get any happen. Okay, so we're also going to have some folks in who are going to be giving. attempts sorting algorithms. So the computer scientists in the room are quite about this, and the others are going to go about it. So I publish in this is a little fun. Okay, so after you've had some fun, work through the night, you'll be given an opportunity to present your hack in the morning. We have to do this tomorrow, so. Presentations will be short, probably around 90 seconds. It's important that you rehearse your presentation, because we're going to have to cut you off to take much longer. Otherwise, the whole event is pretty short. So if I have to interrupt you, we're going to finish the video immediately. So if you rehearse your events and get about 90 seconds, then you don't have to go through all of that. It's also important that you get to the point, state what problem you're having to try to solve. Tell us what technologies you use to build it. Tell us how you solve the problem and show us a quick demonstration of it. Jonathan and Mike later on will be doing a demonstration of how not to hack, so how not to present, and how to present, what will be more information there. So I'm sure I'll be using the definition of how not to present. Right, so judging criteria. So tomorrow there will be judges sitting around here watching your presentations in the back. We have certain criteria that we will be following in order to identify the hacks that they will like. So it must be a working prototype. So PowerPoint will be found upon. It solves a real problem, not a made-up problem. It must use at least one UI technology. We can do that because it's already there. It must be created in some way, have some form of X factor. It must have a great user experience, be unique in some way. And be realistic that it's going to require. So if you are building on something that you've built in the past, just be honest about it in the presentation. That's absolutely fine. But if you tend to build something that's in the huge, you'll probably be wrong. So not a thing. Our esteemed judges will be Mr. Wayne Scatter, who's the CEO. We've got Mr. Virgin Ambuchin, who is the chairperson of the Committee for ITC, the Linux Chamber of Deputies. Mr. Eddie Walker, who is SVP of Media again. Mr. Podge, who is Senior Director for Linux Digital Media Platform. And Dr. Stockford, who we mentioned before, he's the current to his internet sector. The world's foremost learning authority. I don't think anyone should be able to do that. Finally, we have Mr. Alexander Hussain, who is CEO of ExitNet and the Linux. So these are the guys who got to impress. You may wish to get them coffee or something to have an event if you're really good. I'm sure they'll appreciate it. Alright, when it's all over, publish your code on GitHub. There's nothing that we get more upset about is if a great hack is presented on the day and then disappears into obscurity. We like to see them turn into something interesting, and if you don't do anything more with it, then you put it on GitHub and other people can find it and block it and do the interesting things with it. Also, let us know when you do something wrong with it. If your hack turns into a wonderful business or changes the world in some way, we want to know that. Let us know. Stay in touch with other hackers. It's not often that you get so many developers, designers, and talented people in one venue together. You're going to do a lot of networking and meet a lot of interesting people over the next 36 hours. And you know, try spending an hour together, we're all going to be family by the end of the event. Stay in touch with them. Keep in touch with us as well through developer.ai.com/blog where we log in all of our activities for the future. And follow us on Twitter at YDN. Okay, so it's about finishing up, so how to get the most out of this event. So it's important that you get the right skills in your team. There's going to be plenty of developers here, but designers are probably going to be rare. And when you're pitching something in 60 seconds, I've got to say this, it sometimes it really helps if you've got a great user interface or a great user experience. So I'm talking to a designer, a web designer. There's one and you're going to be one. See? Remember who these people are, they can help you. Okay? It turns out if you're a software developer. Yeah, I'm just. It turns out if you're somebody else. Yeah, let's talk later. practice your pitch, that's chapter 4. Do a test drive, come to Jonathan Black's demonstration of how not to pitch later. That's really useful. Find a subject as an expert, so that might be one of the athletes who's an expert on the technologies you want to use. It might be one of the historians or actual physicists or hardware hackers that can help you with something that you're not an expert on. So the enthusiast section will be able to help you with that. And other hackers as well, meet people who are experts in things tweet, but if you need help with something in Python, PhD, whatever, just get help. If you don't have something back, then another hacker might help you. Take breaks where you get tattoo. If you just sit hard at it, you'll probably burn yourself out in the time. So every now and then we'll be at a problem, we'll take a break, come back and work on a solution. Network, community. And most of all, have some fun. It's hard, it's a lighthearted event. It's about having fun, working with other creative people and seeing what happens. We're always surprised by what happened and what happens in these events. We have no idea what we're going to introduce until we get really presented. And that's really a true thing. Okay, before I go, I just want to remind you all that we're a charity interest in this event as well. We're working with Kids on Computers to crowdsource computer equipment that we're going to donate to projects in schools in Romania.